Bismillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala Rasulillah. My dear brothers and my sisters, this is your brother Abdussalam Abu Hanifa. In this morning's pep talk, I want to talk to you about a very scary feeling that I'm getting these days. And that is a lot of the couples today that are married are in fact not happy. Many of them have just settled or trapped in a relationship that if they had any other choice, they would have taken it and break away from where they are today. What I have come to understand is that a lot of the ladies are unhappy in the marriage, but they are trapped. They have children, and they don't see how the future is going to pan out and how is their life going to happen. And a lot of the gents here don't want to talk about their problems, and so is everyone there just having a relationship where actually there is no relationship. It has become two individuals living or sharing an apartment. It's almost like a house share. The relationship, the love, the affection, the endearment, the emotional and the intimate relationship becomes scarce. They never hug, they never kiss, they never touch. They actually don't sit down one evening just to hold a conversation on a different subject or matter. The man goes to work, comes home, plays it tired or gets tired emotionally, and it shows on his body. The woman has done her job with the kids. The kids are in bed, and then she goes to sleep, and the next day is just like yesterday, and tomorrow is like the day before, and so on and so forth. And then they get in touch with me or with somebody else, and they want a solution to their problem, but they don't want to change nothing from where they are today, yet they want a relationship. And this is, as the Chinese people, they say, the definition of madness is doing the same thing over and over to expect only a different result. I have tonight bundled up a few of the advices that I give to people, usually here or there, depending on their situation, but I'm going to share them with you in case one of them will ring a bell and that you're going to start working with that element. But I want to say something before I start here. Your situation will not change if you don't do anything about it. Allah will not resolve your problems. He is not going to send you Jibreel alayhi salam to help you out. You have got to do the hard work, and the results will be given to you by Allah depending on your work. If you do a good job, Allah gives you good results. If you do an evil job, Allah gives you evil results. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not prioritize or scratch your back just because you say La ilaha illallah. In Surah Ibrahim, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Inna Allah la yughayyiru ma biqawmin hatta yughayyiru ma bi anfusihim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not change the status or the situation of a people until and unless they change themselves. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again tells you to put the seed in the ground and then put water in it and take care of it, and Allah gives it life. You don't put a seed on a glass and put water on it and expect a miracle from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring that plant to life. Ain't gonna happen. So the very first thing that I want to bring to your attention is that happiness is not about what you shouldn't say or do, but rather it's about what you show and receive. A lot of the couples, when they get married, the man is only concentrated on one thing, how to get the woman to obey him. He will bring like the 100 or 200, whatever number of ahadith that says that the woman must obey the husband. And she, the poor lady there, she goes, okay, to please Allah, I will obey him. So here it becomes one individual relationship where the man calls the shots and the woman dances to the shots. And after she has a baby or two, and when the relationship goes down south, then she starts jumping up and down as to why the relationship is working, but the damage is done. So here again, your relationship is not about what you shouldn't say or do, but you want to concentrate on actually what you show to your partner and what you receive. And instead of always asking them to give you love, don't ask, do give them the love and let them grow and give you back love. And this is why Islam tells you, take your time Make sure you choose the right partner, because there is more to it than just sharing the bedroom. Marriage is not about only intimacy, or just because he's got a long beard. These days it breaks my heart when I ask the lady, when the couples come to me, one of the questions I ask, and I go, why did you marry him? And the horrible answer comes in, because I thought he was a good Muslim, when she actually doesn't have Islam. So it's like somebody who doesn't know math, and when I ask her, why did you marry him? She goes, because he's a mathematician. How did you come to that judgment that is good math? Oh, it's because he's got a long beard. Is that what it is? And you, my brother, why did you marry her? Oh, I liked her face and she wears hijab. Huh? And then problems hit home, and then they got nothing else to escape these problems. Number two, love between partners is not about changing or breaking your wife up. It's about encouraging her to be her best. A man who is secure in his manhood is not challenged nor threatened by an intelligent wife. In fact, when she is intelligent, he encourages her to become more intelligent. Today, there is a disease between guys, and that is, as soon as he marries the woman, straight away he wants, like a dog, to pee on the tree, to define his frontiers, his realm, his kingdom, that this is me and you belong to me now. This is absolutely nonsense. And Islam doesn't accept it, and the current world does not accept it. Number three, making babies is not a duty, nor it is a responsibility. It's not to show off or please your parents. It's a labor of love. It's a labor of love. A lot of people, when they get married, as soon as they get married, that's it. They open a business called production of babies, and then they start calling this and that. And it's strange that as soon as they give birth to a baby, they take pride in it, and it becomes like the baby defines them, who they are. If they brought up a kid, a boy, then the whole family looks at them with prestige and mashallah. And if they give birth to a girl, what can we do? Allah has given it. We cannot ditch her in a hole. So let's accept her. And this is absolutely vile. Remember, when you married each other, you married each other. You didn't marry their parents. You didn't marry his parents. You didn't marry the people. You didn't marry culture. You married nobody but him, and you married nobody but her. So again, making babies is not a duty, nor is a responsibility. Nobody said that as soon as you get married, next year you gotta have a baby. Nobody said this. And it is sad and extremely heartbreaking that many couples do not have a past together. Usually in normal circumstances, when you meet somebody, and we Muslims, you can't date, so we gotta marry. Alhamdulillah. But once you marry, why don't you start dating each other? Go in vacation. Build a happy set of days or months of years of happiness. You can delay kids, it's no problem. But build a golden era that you can come back to, so that 10 years from now, 20 years from now, 15 years or 7 years from now, when you run into problems, if someone asks you, what is the best time of your lives that you spent together, you can go back, you go, you know what, it was the first 4 years we really had a blast. And then I can tell you pretty much, why can't you have the same blast today? Why don't you do what you have done before and be happy like you were before happy, and then you've got something to get back to. A lot of the times I ask people, when was the last time, when did you have absolutely great time as a couple, as two people, not a husband and wife, as a lover and a loveress woman? Guess what? They don't have nothing. They really have, oh, we went holidays to Vietnam. How long was the holidays for? Well, it was a week. That's all you can account for? A week? You've been married together for 10 years and you don't have a golden era to get back to? Well, your marriage is bound to break. Again, you are in a relationship with each other, not with his or her parents, not with the family. And what matters is you too, not what your parents, her parents, or people think of you. You don't care, absolutely do not care. most of the problems here today that happens is because the man marries the woman, but actually it's not the man who has married the woman. It's the man, his mother, his brother, his family, his culture, and his job, and his everything that are married to the woman. And the woman has to do everything to please the man. And these people, the couple does not live together for each other. They live together because of the culture, because of horrible customs. And this is absolutely deteriorating and devastating to both the couple and to your sanity. So you want to really stop living for your family and for your culture and become people that live for each other. And also remember, when you married, you mentioned the name of Allah. You followed the Quran and the Sunnah. Why during the marriage you follow the Quran and the Sunnah of the culture and your family? Don't do it. Don't do it. Your parents, put them in their spot. And for your information, my brothers and my sisters, you, my sisters, it is not your duty to care for his parents. You've got nothing. And you, my brother, also, it's not your duty to care for her parents. You are married to each other. One of the great problems that I face when I deal with a couple, and this is only with Muslims, subhanAllah, I think there is a curse, not only on the Jews, but also on the Muslims. When you deal in a couple with a problem, any problem, as long as it hasn't gone beyond a certain point, because there is a point, once problems go beyond it, there is no return back. And that is, even if you recite the whole Quran in 1 hour, there is no point in returning back. However, as a couple, you want to make sure that the problem here is not who wins and loses, but it is more about give and take, compromise. Again, many problems happen is because one of the two wants to win. And usually it's the man at the beginning, and he keeps pushing his bad acts, until the woman goes beyond a certain point of no return. And then the man wants to reconcile or just sort out the problems, and it's just not possible. So again, as a couple, don't forget to play and laugh, not to take life too serious. Wallahi al-azim. It's really, really degrading that a whole couple, you live together for 10 years and you can't account for 1 month of good time together. So what kind of relationship did you build? Again, here is another element that I find also these days in Muslim married couples is that many people, and especially men, are mature age-wise, but they are very immature marriage-wise. My brothers, let me tell you something. Your wife, if you have that kind of good attitude, the alpha male, the leader, the lion of the pack, the woman can follow you to the end of the world. But sadly, a lot of men, they have gone beyond the 30s, but when it comes to marriage, they are still in kindergartens. They don't even know what it is to be a father or more, a husband. A woman's heart is one with chocolate. A hug and a smile, not by authority, frown, and a set of commands. You must obey me. If you don't obey me, you're going to go to hellfire. These kind of things get you nowhere. You're dealing with the heart. For the love of Allah, stop terrorizing your women. Stop putting them under your boots. Yeah, he put your woman on top of the head. There is no problem at all. She's not going to wear your blue jeans. She is a woman. She is a woman. Again, my brothers, your woman, your wife, is a human being with a heart, emotions, dreams, desires. Don't break all these beautiful things just to prove yourself that you are the one who runs the marriage. This is a huge mistake. Most marriages will break if any of one of the three that I'm going to mention are present in the marriage. The very first one is when the husband becomes a total owner of the whole relationship. And he uses all the ahadith possible, all the Quran possible, all the sayings of the scholars possible, just to take control and dictate what he wants to the woman. If she doesn't obey, she's destined to hellfire. If the relationship is like this, wave it, assalamu alaikum, because the woman can be passive for a month, two, three, but one day she will explode and she's going to rebel against you. Number two, when you do that, the woman is going to obey you, but that is fake obedience. Or she is forced to obey and create that element of, okay, I'll listen because Allah, 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 and this will not last. And number three is the relationship becomes a school-like. The father runs after dunya, and the mother becomes this and that, and the owners of the whole family just take care for the kids. The man and the woman don't have time for each other. If they have an intimate relationship once a month, they can be kings and queens. But this is not the right solution. Couples these days, Muslim couples, fit into one of these examples. Some couples act like two roosters, while some others act like two peaceful chicken living in peace. Others act like a dictator rooster with this emblem, my way or the hellfire, while the lady acts like a total passive chicken. The majority today act like a chicken who tries to become a rooster, but the rooster refuses to become a chicken. Then after a baby or two, they both are neither a rooster nor a chicken. Nobody knows what they are anymore. They just become a father and they just become a mother, but they don't become a husband and a wife. They become Abu this and this. It's like two people who buy a car, and then she has her car and he has the car, and then they become owner of this car and owner of that car. They don't no longer relate to each other. A failed marriage is like somebody who doesn't take care of their hygiene. Dirty people don't like to be called dirty, even though that's who they are. But because being called dirty means you don't know how to clean yourself. A lot of Muslims today keep their problems hidden. Nobody knows about them because they are scared of being labeled as losers, even though that's who they are. Other times, the husband tells the woman not to tell anyone about their problems so that he can abuse her to no end, and she's got nothing to do with that. I get really surprised that somebody has been in problems for 5, 6, 7 years, and only when I ask her, does anyone know of these problems? She goes, no, nobody knows. Then when she tells her family that she is having problems, everybody is surprised. Why'd you do that to yourself? Why'd you do that to yourself? Why'd you allow somebody to abuse you? Lots of married couples don't know the true meaning of the loving bond of marriage. Believe it or not, it's just when somebody gets to a certain age, it has become like a something to do. It doesn't come out of love. Let me tell you something. Marriage happens one of the two. Either you love somebody and you marry them, or you marry someone and you love them. Your situation, you didn't marry for love at all, or hardly ever it happens. Sometimes it breaks my heart when a young lady gets taken back home to come back with a pre-arranged marriage. And then the first thing to do, they have the first night, the baby is born, and she is stuck in a goddamn relationship. She can't escape it because she has children and she can do nothing. Somebody gets in touch with me and they say, I am married to this man and I have 4 or 5 children or 2 children, but I can't divorce him because I have children, but I'm sick and tired of this marriage. And my answer is always, once you know what you want, get back to me and I'll help you, because I really don't want to waste my time with someone who, as I said, the Chinese madness, that they keep doing the same thing and they expect different results. Somebody once said that there are people who live in darkness for years and they can't break away until darkness becomes their reality, until darkness becomes their end. And subhanAllah, divorce is something that Allah has made halal. But sadly so, a lot of people are scared of divorce because they think once they divorce, they can't get nothing. And this is where إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ comes in hand. So my question to you is, before you cry that you have a problem, let me ask you a question. How much did you allow this problem to take over your life? And how much are you willing to let it again control your life? SubhanAllah, we live in England. You don't live in some land where you can't say a word. You live in England. Do something about it. Children, so many people are divorced, so many things. Do not allow abuse to go any further. This is again your brother Abdussalam Abu Hanifa, and I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enable us to come out of these problems. If a lot of Muslims today are sad and their marriage is not working, I really feel sorry for the children that are going to grow. You can cry all you want, my sister, but Allah will not change your status until you do something about it. And let me tell you something, my sisters. Don't be scared of divorce. There are plenty of single men out there who will treat you tons better than the rooster that you get here called me, my way, or the highway. Please open your eyes. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.